Greetings everyone, and welcome to a new Outriders video. Today I'm sharing with you a different kind of anomaly power build. We're going to not use the best set, which is the Akari, because I wanted to try how good is the Reforged and the Lava Lich set. And in today's video we're going to explore the Reforged set, what pieces we can use, what build we can utilize in order to do challenge tier 15 expeditions in gold timers without so much problem. So without any further delay, let's have a closer look at the build, starting with the three pieces of the Reforged set we are going to use: the helmet, the chest and the legs. Compared to the gloves and the boots, these three pieces have the best mods we can use. The boots could be comparable to the helmet because both of them have max health instead of anomaly power. Also, the gloves are the same, but unfortunately the gloves have the worst mods available, and I did prefer to go with the headpiece because of the mods I finally chose to go with. In specific, we're going to use the following armor mods. The tier 1s are Fire Frenzy, Pants on Fire and Blacksmith. Only one tier 2 mod, which is the Damage Absorber, and in order to compensate for the lack of raw power compared to the Akari set, all the other mods are tier 3: Double Fan, Branded, Master Consumer, Flame Grasper, Detonator and Captain Hunter. I did try running the build without the Blacksmith, and in some occasions, especially against alphas, it was a little troubling surviving, so Blacksmith is one of the best survivability for anomaly power Pyromancer builds. Even consuming one status effect gives you the same amount of armor compared to the Damage Absorber, and so consuming more than one can help you survive in the toughest situations. Because our single target DPS is not the best, that's why I'm using the Master Consumer. Although this usually is combined with Ash Blast, we are going to combine it a little bit with Feed the Flames or our skills that apply the Ash status effect to the enemies, plus the burning effect from the Thermal Bomb will make sure to kill those elites easier. And that's why we also combine it with Captain Hunter to have a less problem dealing with all the elites we face. For the weapons, my primary choice is not the Death Shield, but an Assault Rifle or another weapon with longer range, such as the Hair to the Desert, by applying the Fortress mod on it, because we need to finish off some enemies on long range when we apply the Thermal Bomb. So that's why I chose that over the Death Shield, although my secondary choice and my sidearm is the Anemoi and the Torment and Agony, having both of them the Moaning Wits, in order to help us a little bit with more AoE damage, because we have a little downtime using our skills based on our cooldowns. We can use the Guillotine as an alternative option, applying the Moaning Wits, so you can have a super, let's say, AoE mod when using that. The skills we're going to use are the Feed the Flames, Thermal Bomb and Overheat, although after some testing, Feed the Flames, as you can see the background, doesn't deal as much damage compared to the other skills. However, I was determined to fit it in because of the Reforged set, and for this case we are going to use it as a survivability tool along with an anomaly power boost. As you can see, that's why in the background we use this specific spec, because in this case we can use the Feed the Flames to get the 45% anomaly power boost, and we also get advantage of the almost full Tempest 3 for maximum damage output. Our rotation works a little different compared to other builds, because Feed the Flames doesn't have the same range compared to Thermal Bomb or Overheat, that's usually the range of the map. So we open with an Overheat and use the Thermal Bomb and our weapon mods to deal with enemies afar. Once we are in medium to close range, we start to prioritize Feed the Flames to get the anomaly power boost. We're using the Thermal Bomb to apply the debuff and kill as many enemies as we can. And once we use the combination of Feed the Flames, Thermal Bomb and Overheat for maximum damage output, we can make sure that smaller enemies can explode closer to larger enemies for maximum AoE damage. And we also have to make full use of our secondary weapon modes, the Moaning Wits, which will take a huge part in our rotation. So first things first, before we start every expedition, make sure to empty the clip from your secondary weapon and your sidearm, because we are going to utilize that to make the Moaning Witch rotation easier. Here's an example how it works. For maximum efficiency, first make sure to shoot with your primary weapon to proc your first mod. Switch to your secondary weapon. Now, because the clip is empty, we will automatically reload proking Moaning Winds. Before we manage to reload, switch to your sidearm, proking a second time Moaning Winds. Then you have to switch to your previous weapon, which will be the secondary weapon with an epic clip. So you have to re-switch to your primary weapon in order to avoid completely reloading your weapons, because we need to repeat this process for maximum damage, especially against targets affected by two thermal bomb debuffs, dealing to them 80% extra damage. Let's move on to a couple of tips while using the build. Make sure thermal bomb hits lower health targets and they explode next to higher health targets that are also affected by thermal bomb. Thanks to our mods, thermal bomb hits two targets at once, so with some practice you will be able to hit all the targets you want and to maximize its effect, dealing maximum amount of damage, because this is our second highest damaging skill when running the expeditions. Our number one damaging skill is the overheat, so make sure to use it on cooldown. Even without having a status effect, thanks to Patch on Fire, it still deals a nice amount of damage. Compared to other builds, we don't apply burn to so many enemies and as often, and thus our survivability is a little lower. Our highest amount of healing comes from killing enemies, and then from Feed the Flames, although the latter has a 10 seconds cooldown, so you cannot rely your survivability based on that. With that in mind, you have to utilize cover. Thankfully, all our skills can meet fire behind cover, and you don't have to face tank the elites. They are the most dangerous enemies, especially the behemoths, the brute mothers, and also the alpha, so try to crowd control them with overheat, thermal bomb, and Moaning Winds that all stuns them. But be extra careful of the crawlers. If they are immune to interrupt, you cannot stun them, so make sure to take your distance, because one of their attacks, the one that smashes the ground and unleashes a blue flame underneath, can kill you very fast if you are in close range and you cannot stun them. Feed the Flames, although not the highest damaging skill, we will utilize it for healing, crowd control, and anomaly power boost, although you could save it in some situations to, for example, crowd control 3 alphas. I do recommend to use it on cooldown, not only for the healing, but mostly for the 45% anomaly power boost. When all your skills and Moaning Winds are on cooldown, don't be afraid to utilize your primary weapon, especially something similar to Hair to the Desert, deals a very good amount of damage, especially to targets affected by thermal bomb. Finally, let's explore the advantages and disadvantages using this build. For one, the advantages are the instant cast skills. Some people dislike even the flame wave, and of course the phaser beam that has a casting time. So if you do not like this type of skills and you want to go with an anomaly power build, this is something you should definitely try. We potentially can have the best stun lock out there. All our skills and Moaning Winds can do so. Basically, you can stun lock most of the enemies to death. But let's move on to the disadvantages, because they're not as few as I hoped. Our survivability is not the best compared to other builds. Most of our healing comes from killing the enemies, and Feed the Flames will get you out of tough situations, but it's not a consistent source of healing because of the 10 seconds cooldown. The Reforged Set itself doesn't have the best attributes we want. Not only the helmet has maximum health instead of anomaly power, 3 out of 3 pieces have long range damage bonus, which we prefer to be something else, especially on the chest, that also lacks cooldown reduction. And finally, because of that, we could make a better build without using all the Reforged Set bonus pieces. We can also replace Feed the Flames, because honestly, it's not the most impressive DPS skill for an anomaly power build. Even when we get the 45% bonus, it's not worth it to waste, let's say, all these talent points to deviate so as much, and we can probably use epic gear pieces with a few legendary pieces without a set bonus in particular, and replace Feed the Flames with, let's say, Eruption or another skill and make ourselves a much better build. So in conclusion, this build is not the best compared to other Anomaly Power builds, but it can do challenge tier 15 expeditions in gold. I tried most of them and didn't have so much problem after getting used to it, and it's a build definitely for those people that dislike Flame Wave and Phaser Beam, and you can definitely give it a try. I do recommend to try the build using the 3 Reforged pieces before finding any epic pieces that can upgrade it a little bit, because they are easier to get, and in this way you can use so many tier 3 mods to compensate with a lack of raw power compared to, let's say, the Akari build, and it's easier to assemble. Personally, I'm still trying to find some epic pieces to make an upgraded version of this build without using the Feed the Flames, and if I'm lucky and find those, I will definitely make a separate video to see how this works. Next up is trying the Lava Lich set to see how good of an Anomaly Power we can build. Thank you very much for taking the time to watch my video. Feel free to like if you liked, and I really hope this video would help you find your own Anomaly Power build for the Pyromancer. So subscribe to stay tuned for more upcoming videos for Outriders and other video games, and have a wonderful day, everyone.
Thank you.